sabihin nila hindi mo kaya. Magpakita ng gilas at huwag matakot. Hindi ka naman nag-iisa. Bawat hirap ng panahon, papangon tayo sa pagluhon. Kayo, sugod, laban, Pilipino. Kayo, sugod, laban,
basketball. Just this one word will bring Filipinos to a standstill. Playing on their makeshift courts to kids trying to make their dads proud, most of us know what it is like to pick up a basketball and dream big. Whether it's a simple game among friends where pride is at stake, or street bets and pickup games, basketball is in every corner of every town and every city. There are village leagues where glory among friends, families, and neighbors are most coveted, to inter-barangays where the best of the village are chosen to compete against other barangays. Office games are played after the grueling 9-to-5 work shift as a way to de-stress. And Filipinos way past their prime take to the sidelines to cheer for the younger generation. Basketball is played every day, where winning is always of utmost importance. The intense competition burns even deeper, as college-level athletes compete with their school names emblazoned on their jerseys. The game brings together total strangers who stand as witnesses in a packed arena, united by school pride. There are millions who dream of playing in the big leagues, like the PBA, and some dream even bigger, like the NBA. The passion of Filipinos for this game is undying. When the Philippines' honor is at stake, pride and passion take on a completely new level. Out of the millions who have picked up a basketball and started to dream, only a handful of gentlemen have been selected to take on this big task of representing the country we all love so dearly. This is Gilas Pilipinas. and this is the story of their journey to FIBA Asia. The goal is to finish third place or better, and winning here takes them a step closer to the 2014 World Basketball Tournament at Madrid, Spain.
The privilege to be part of the national team is really big. I mean, we're one of the 1 million players here in the Philippines na nandito kami. Diba, 12 kami nandito, 13 kami nandito. Siguro maraming nangangarap na basketball player, but then nandito kami. We're very fortunate na nandito kami.
And of course, the ultimate goal is to see this team waving our flag in the next Olympics.
Kailangan pakita natin sa buong bayan na manalo tayo. Siyempre, ayaw naman natin na bumaba tayo sa expectation ng mga iba, no? So kailangan talaga pag nasupport na, all out. No? Basta ako pag naglaro ko, bigay ko lahat. Lalo na host tayo, manonood buong Pilipinas, all out, bigay mo na lahat, puso. Yun nga nun, ang lagi sinisigaw namin, di ba? Parang puso.
Puso! Tamang Pilipinas!
Puso!
Kahit ano yan, dive for the ball or what, bigay na lang.
Wow, alam yun, sobrang saya. Very proud ako na, you know, ang daming player o Pilipinong gusto maglaro dito. Tapos parang ako yung isang napili. Blessed naman na natanggap ako, kinuha ko ni coach. So ibibigay ko talaga yung 100% ko, ibibigay ko kung talaga yung natutunan ko sa basketball.
This team is perfect. Okay. Perfect na talaga yung team na to na binuo ni coach. We have big guys that can shoot outside, we have big guys can move inside. I think we have big guys can run the floor, which is our system.
Different now, yeah. I get to play four and I can, I'm more confident with Greg and Jumar that I have someone in the back to help me if I, you know, go to contest the shot. I don't have to too much worry about always having to get down and get the rebound because now we got taller guys, so.
To the post. Okay, don't let him go middle. Get in front of that backcourt, cut him off on that turn, give me your down.
We have shooters and we have, you know, great point guards nandyan din on the lineup din, di ba?
You know, without a doubt, this team is probably the most talented team that I've been a part of with my experience with the national team. You know, we have a great group of guys, some veteran guys, some young guys. This is by far the most hype we've had for our national team, probably in a long time, if maybe the first time.
The confidence level that I have in those guys is definitely more than I had before in the, you know, on a previous team. So that's definitely going to help the team out overall, because then I can take more chances now knowing that I have Jumar and Greg in the back.
So it's exciting. You know, it's exciting for me. You know, obviously this being my last tour of duty with the team and getting an opportunity to play with, obviously, with Jason and even with LA, who I think are two of the top young guards in the league today. And just being here, really just taking in the whole experience. You know, to be back with Coach Chud and to still have Coach Norman here. And again, you know, we just have a really, really talented group of guys.
You got to take it as just an exciting time. You got to take it for what it is. Enjoy the game. Enjoy the moment. And I compare it to the Final Four. You know, I played in the Final Four in college, luckily enough, and was blessed to be in that situation. And our coach just said, enjoy it. You know what I mean? It's a once in a lifetime thing. And if you overthink it, that's when you start not to play your game.
Nandiyan pa rin yan, yung defense number one yan. Siyempre, yun, katulad sinabi ko, yung energy kasi dyan naman tayo nakikilala sa basketball. Siyempre, for me naman, para sa sarili ko naman, mas may po yun siguro yung mga shooting sa labas, yung mga ano ko pa, kung ano yung mas kulang para sa akin, yun yung tututukan ko.
Eventually it has to get cut down to 12, so I think we'll still be over 12.
How's that going for you, so having a familiar face?
It's good, you know, having Jeff here, and then, you know, Bo has just naturally just worked hard and kind of gained more and more respect every year in the league, and he deserves to be here, there's no doubt about it.
I think we have a good shot for the top 3 slot in this FIBA Asia.
We actually had a great first week of practice together with all the guys, so it's pretty encouraging at this stage of where we're at. You know, the guys that come in here and work really hard and still have a long road to go, but really encouraging this first week.
The task of defending our country's pride falls on the shoulders of the mighty men of Gilas Pilipinas, as the last time the Philippines had home court in the FIBA Asia Tournament was 40 years ago. We won that tournament.
And next, for the past couple of days, let's get your minds back to this ball game. The most important thing, guys, if they make a shot, take it out right away and let's see if we can outrun them. They've got their big guys on the floor, they make a shot, quick inbound, run the net of the floor.
And with a huge responsibility on their shoulders comes a commitment and sacrifice that each of them willingly give for the cause.
Gentlemen, we got 61 days. 61 days to history. Okay, 61 days. So it's going to be a good, hard, long trip, but it's also going to be over.
Unang-una akong na-sacrifice dito yung team namin kasi yung token text, marami rin kaming sacrifice kasi maraming player sa amin. Pag naglaro ka sa bansa kasi lahat kaya mong i-sacrifice yun.
What's gonna happen is Bo's just gonna come down here and do this.
For most, they jumped straight from the PBA season to Gilas training camp.
In my team, we're the first one who got eliminated. So I only took one day off. And then I started working already because I know I only have like 2 weeks before the team training start. So I wanted to come to training camp really in good shape. So I was working 2 times a day, morning and the evening. So just to get in shape.
All of them also know that right after the FIBA tournament, they go straight into the next PBA conference, leaving no room for rest for the next 10 months.
Knowing that the PBA is on break, lahat ng mga teammates ko ang 2 months ang bakasyon. Me or kami, nagpa-practice kami ngayon. After 1 week, nagpa-practice na kami, di ba? Kasi after this, we'll go straight to PBA. Kami na siguro yung group of players na walang pahinga talaga.
Ready? Let's go!
Dalawang buwan ang bilis ng dadaan. Before we know it, it's upon us.
Substitution, Javon Aguilar for Marcus Dalton.
2 months is not that long. It's gonna come really quick. So yeah, we're doing everything we can right now. We're really serious. We're working really, really hard.
In the midst of all the hard work, preparation, and sacrifice, for every Gilas player, life still goes on. And time with family and friends will need to be set aside for now. Or, like Gabe Norwood, squeezing in his wedding and all the training and travel plans is required.
I will be getting married in right there in Honolulu, in Hawaii, actually outside of Honolulu, but on the same same island, on Oahu, at a place called Secret Island. It's actually pretty popular with my family. We have our family reunions there in Hawaii, so it's up in the air. It all comes down to how, you know, the basketball schedule works with Gilas, and then also the PBA schedule. A lot of overlapping goes on, so we're basically playing 11 months out of the year, so it's tough to kind of schedule a honeymoon, but the idea is actually Croatia.
Larry is a homebody who spends most of his time with his wife and kid. They are expecting their second child anytime soon. But unlike before, he now has to spend it away from his expecting wife.
Well, because we're very hands-on and because we're both, well, I'm full-time, but you know, my husband is also a full-time dad when you think about it. I'm 30 years old, and I have a baby on the way. We have another baby coming in October. And my name is...
My name is
Leon, and
I'm 4 years old.
You're older, so I'm 4 years old. Yeah.
Leaving my pregnant wife at home and my kid, you know, hindi kami sanay na magkahiwalay. And, year-round kasi nasa bahay lang ako and just helping on hands-on parent, and right now it's really tough.
We're very close to the point of clinginess. So, because our days are spent together talaga. It's just us. It's just me, my son, and my husband. So, when one of us is away, we really feel it. We really feel a shift in the dynamic here at home because it's just us nga.
My motivation to play here is, you know, to make the fans proud then for our country, and also to lay a foundation for my kid, just in case he wants to follow my footsteps, and you know, just him to see his dad play and international. Maybe it's something for him to aim for when he grows up.
Gary David and LA Tenorio also have their own stories of family and young kids.
Not being with our families for longest time, like this Lithuania trip, like 14 days to be exact, we'll be back like in the 18th. So, tagal lang sa pamilya, and then after 4, or I think 5 days, we'll fly again.
Gary, pag may time siya, mas madala siya dito kasi sa bahay. Pag wala siyang practice, pag wala siyang laro, dito lang siya. Ang kadalasang bonding ng kids siya ni Gary, nag-watch siya ng movie, nag-mall. Eldest ko si Maxine, second is Gariel, and the third one is Jayla. Willing naman akong mag-sacrifice din for him kung makakapasok ang Philippines sa 2014 World Championship. pag may game sila dito sa Philippines, lagi kami nanonood. Kasama ko yung kids. Tapos pag nada-down siya, lagi ko siyang sinasabihan na okay lang yan, makakabawi siya kung bad game siya, ganun.
Shoot, Daddy!
And even in the early stages of the journey, it has not been without setbacks.
Another opportunity, dear Lord, to represent our country.
You know, you got two just top-notch guys right there with Kelly and JD. Especially, you know, Kelly, he was my roommate my first time on the national team in 07 in Japan. JD, I've grown really close with over the years, and you know, it's just tough. You know, on the court, having that athleticism, their ability to play different positions, but then off the court, they're just good team guys. You know, bought into the system that Coach Chott started with them at Talking Text, and their transition to the national team was easy. So it just takes a little bit more on our part to kind of fill their roles and everybody to step up.
You know, with Kelly, I think more so than obviously he's a former MVP, the athleticism, and it's the person, you know, the spiritual leader, the just his presence here on the court. You know, we're going to miss. You know, we miss it now here with Gilas. We miss it with Talking Text, but, you know, it's unfortunate. But at the same time, you know, Kelly had to make a tough choice that was best for himself and his family. So, you know, we understand and we obviously miss him. But at the same time, we're all hoping that he recovers and who knows, maybe he comes back. With Jared, it's tough losing him because he's so, I think Jared's biggest strength is his versatility. You know, especially for FIBA competition, JD can really guard 1, 2, 3 and sometimes 4. So losing that versatility on our team, you know, definitely hurts. But, you know, luckily, you know, we still have Ping, we have Gabe who can step into those shoes and obviously puts a little bit more pressure on them because, you know, not having Jared with us.
The difference is now this is the team that we're going to go with. Last time we, you know, the last 2 weeks before the tournament, we added in Jimmy, Ronnie Dale, mm-hmm. and Kelly. So it kind of switched things up at the very end, you know, just before we get ready to start. But now we've been prepping so far with these guys for the last month and a half, and now we get to finally get up and down and play each other physical and, you know, try to push each other to the level to where we need to be at. Because right now we're not there. Good thing, you know, the tournament will start tomorrow, but I'm quite sure I have the confidence that we're going to get there when it's that time.
Malaking bagay din sa team sila, Kelly, yung energy na binibigay nila, yung mga rebounds, so alam yun. So ngayon, yun kumbaga, para sa akin, yun naman siguro yung ibibigay ko ngayon sa team.
From this point on, nothing is certain except that there will be bumps along the road. And the task of pushing forward and rising above will be one of the biggest challenges this team needs to face. For now, training camp is here, and preparations have stepped up a notch, and the team gears up for a 20-hour flight to Lithuania. This is Gilas Pilipinas.
I grew up with a father who was in athletics. My dad is a college football coach in the States. So I'm used to kind of making the most of the time with dad. So having my two sons, having Cassius and Orion there, especially at an early stage, you know, you want to be influential for your kids. So you got to make the most of what you have.
To jumpstart this voyage or this journey to FIBA Asia, this is a perfect fit.
I think a pleasant revelation is how these guys are able to get along. You know, we have superstars from different teams, but when you see them together and be with them, you really see the genuine camaraderie. And these guys really enjoy being around each other, you know?
We've been hearing about Lithuania for the longest time. We know that Lithuania is as crazy a basketball country as us in the Philippines. And, well, you can't argue with Lithuania's success. They're number five. They're ranked number five in the FIBA standings. And I guess it would be good to learn from the best.
I must admit, though, it's not yet, you know, with 1.5 months before FIBA Asia, we're not yet at the level that we wanted to be. But, you know, it is what it is. So we are just making the most out of it.
We've got to improve on our defense against a bigger and faster team because the Middle East countries will be the same.
Big pleasure to to cooperate and to work and to help, and we got a lot of discussions, and honestly I can tell that I learned a lot of things also.